When it's cold and miserable outside, the last thing you want is for your home to be cold and miserable as well. So today I'm going to show you four cheap and easy ways to boost your radiator so that your home heats up faster and feels warmer. So how do radiators transfer heat? Most of the heat transfer is due to hot air rising and forming a convection current. The rest is due to infrared radiation. Everything gives off infrared radiation, and the hotter something is, the more radiation it gives off. We feel this radiation as heat, and it spreads out or radiates in all directions. To be able to give off heat by convection and radiation, radiators need space. If you put objects like furniture in front of a radiator, the radiated heat is going to go into the furniture and not into the room. And if you restrict the airflow to the radiator, you're stopping a convection current forming, which is the main form of heat transfer. So the first thing we need to do is keep radiators clear of obstructions. And this includes clothes, especially wet ones. My wife drives me mad with this. If we look at this through a thermal imaging camera, look at the difference it makes. If you look down the centre or the back of most radiators, you'll find there's an arrangement of fins. These are to increase the surface area so that you get more heat transfer to the air, but they're also to create a chimney effect so that the hot air rises and it pulls in cold air underneath. Clothes on top of the radiator will block this chimney effect and reduce heat transfer. But clothes are not the only thing that could be stopping convection. If you look down inside the fins, if they've not been cleaned for a while, they could be filthy. This dust is going to seriously inhibit airflow. So the second thing we need to do is clean the radiator. There are two easy ways you can clean the dust out from between the fins. A hairdryer on maximum power will blow most of the dust out through the bottom of the vents. This is an example of what came out of one radiator using the hairdryer. But a hairdryer is not actually the best way to do this. Even after blowing it through with a hairdryer, there was still quite a bit of dust left in there. The best method I've found is to use a radiator brush. These are like long thin bottle brushes. This one's 80 centimetres long. And you simply push the brush down into and between the fins to clean the dust out. Works really well. I got this one from Amazon. I think it cost about £8. I'll put a link in the description below. A top tip, if you get one of the brushes with bristles rather than the microfiber ones, you don't have to take the grid off the top of your radiator. So this clip shows how much extra dust I managed to get out of the radiator using the brush. This was on top of what I'd previously got out using the hairdryer. So you can see the brush does a much better job. I've seen quite a few people recommending radiator fans to increase airflow. Personally, I've not used them, so I can't recommend them, but they do seem quite expensive. The third way I'm going to improve the output of my radiators is to reduce the amount of wasted radiant heat. Radiant heat's given off in all directions, so a large part of it falls on the wall. Now, the wall absorbs this radiant heat, and you can see it's warming up nicely. I don't want to waste money heating that wall. I want that energy going into the room, so I'm going to try and reflect it back into the room. And a material that's really good at reflecting infrared radiation is aluminium foil. So the third way to boost the radiators is to fit aluminium foil behind the radiators to reflect infrared heat back into the room. I used a roll of foam-back foil from Aldi, but all the DIY stores sell something suitable. I'll put some links in the description below. A single roll should be big enough for most homes, so it's not going to cost a lot of money. But I found it made a noticeable difference. You can see how reflective the foil is here. To fit the foil, you've got several options. Some rolls come with adhesive pads. Others recommend using wallpaper paste. But really, that means you're going to have to take the radiator off. Personally, I prefer to cut a wooden rod that's long enough to sit on the brackets of the radiator. I then cut a piece of the foil about 50 millimetres smaller than the radiator in each direction. That way the foil won't be as visible from the rest of the room.
So that's how I fixed it together. And now I'm just going to slot it down the back. It should rest on those supports. Sorted. unless you look for it.
It's a lot easier than trying to paste it to the wall. If the brackets are a long way from the edge of the radiator, you can cut slots in the foil to accommodate the brackets and then just slide it down either side of them. Now these three changes will make the most difference if the radiator is actually full of hot water. If it isn't, the radiator is not going to heat up evenly and you're not going to get as much heat out of it as you should. If this is the case, you'll find that either the top of the radiator or the bottom of the radiator is cooler than the rest. If it's the bottom of the radiator that's cold, it's mainly due to the buildup of sludge which is blocking the radiator. This sludge is due to corrosion and it's a form of iron oxide called magnetite. The best way to get rid of it is to have the system power flushed, but it's expensive, it'll cost you several hundred pounds. If it's the top of the radiator that's cold, however, that's a much easier job. That's due to air in the system. Air is less dense than water, so it goes to the top of the radiator, and it's also a poorer conductor of heat, which is why the top of the radiator then feels cool. So the fourth way to boost the output from our radiators is to make sure they're full of water by bleeding them. To do this, you'll need a radiator bleed key. These only cost about £1 if you haven't already got one. And an old cloth. Before you do this though, make sure you know how to repressurise your boiler, because quite often you'll get a fall in the pressure, and if it drops too low, your boiler won't fire up. So to bleed a radiator, make sure the system's off and it's cool. And at the top of the radiator at one end, you'll find a square valve like this. The other end should be blank. Place the cloth behind and below the valve to catch any water that escapes, and then put the radiator key onto the valve and slowly turn it anti-clockwise until you start to hear a hiss. This is air escaping through the valve. When water starts coming out of the valve, shut it down quickly. The radiator is now full of water, so you can clean it up and move on to the next one. Work your way through the rest of the radiators in the house, and then if necessary, repressurise your boiler. Then you're done. So I hope you found this video useful. If you have, leave a thumbs up. Any questions, leave a comment below. And don't forget to subscribe to Big Ted's Home and Garden. I'll see you soon.